हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स। टिल नाउ वी हैव गॉन थ्रू द वीडियोस ऑन रेक्टिफायर्स एंड द टाइप्स ऑफ रेक्टिफायर्स एंड आफ्टर दैट वी हैव आल्सो सीन द कैपेसिटर फिल्टर and inductor filter. Now this is the part 2 of the filters. Here we will complete today the filters. In front of you, I am Lalit Kumar P. Bhaiya, Associate Professor, Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering Department, Bharati College of Engineering and Technology, Durg. Let us move ahead. We will go now through the combination of inductor and capacitor filter, that is LC filter. LC filter, what the LC filter do? The ripple factor is directly proportional to the load resistance RL in case of the inductor filter, and inversely proportional to the load resistance RL in case of the capacitor filter. Try to remember, ripple factor is directly proportional when we connect the inductor at the output, and inversely proportional when we connect the capacitor at the output. Therefore, if these two filters are combined as LC filter, or it is also called as a L section filter, as shown in figure below, you can see this figure, the ripple factor will be independent of load resistance. See, this is the LC filter. Here, this is the full wave rectifier output given as an input here. This is inductor, that is choke, and this is capacitor C. Always capacitor is connected in parallel with the load, while inductor is connected in series with the load. So this filter is called as a LC filter. And this LC filter, I have already told you ripple factor is directly proportional to this L and inversely proportional to this capacitor. And hence, this will improve the filter. Here, this LC filter with bridge rectifier is shown here. This is the bridge. This is input waveform, transformer, and this is bridge wave rectifier. Full wave rectifier, full wave bridge rectifier, you can say. And here you will get this dotted output as an output of the rectifier. And after this L and C combination, this is L and this is C combination, you will get this output. That means the most of the ripples are removed by this LC filter. Right? Then from the Fourier series, the output voltage can be expressed as V naught is equal to twice Vm by pi minus 4 Vm by 3 pi cos 2 omega t. And here all other higher order components are removed because they are consisting very small ripple. So no need to write these components. The DC output voltage VDC is equal to twice Vm by pi as we have already seen. And the VRMS is equal to IRMS into XC because output is taken across the capacitor. And hence, the output RMS voltage, that is ripple RMS voltage, is equal to IRMS into reactance of the capacitor. That is equal to root 2 by 3 VDC into XC by XL. XL is the in series combination, reactance of the inductance. This is reactance of the capacitor. Then this ripple factor is given by this gamma or R, you can say VRMS upon VDC, that is equal to root 2 by 3 into XC by XL. And finally, it comes to be root 2 by 3 into 1 upon 4 omega square C into L, where XC is equal to 1 upon 2 pi omega C, 1 upon omega C, and XL is equal to omega L. You can put here, you will get this 2 omega L and 2 omega C. And this is about the LC filter. Now we will go for this CLC filter, that is also called as a pi filter. The capacitor input filter, also called as a pi filter, due to its shape that looks like the Greek letter pi, is a type of electronic filter. Filter circuits are used to remove unwanted or undesired frequencies from a signal. This is C1, L, this is C2, CLC filter. And this looks like a pi shape, therefore it is called as pi filter. And here is the load resistance RL at the output. And at the input, we will apply the output of the rectifier, full wave rectifier. Either it may be a bridge rectifier or it may be a center tap rectifier. So this is CLC filter. A typical capacitor input filter consists of a filter capacitor C1 connected across the rectifier output, a choke L in series, and another filter capacitor connected across the load, as seen in the previous diagram. This is CLC pi filter, shown C1, C2, and this is inductor, full wave rectifier, rectified input, and this is the load resistance RL. This is the diagram of the CLC or pi filter. The above figure shows a CLC or P type of filter, which basically consists of a capacitor filter followed by LC section. This filter offers a fairly smooth output and is characterized by highly peaked diode currents and poor regulation. As in L section filter, the analysis is obtained as followed. This is the ripple factor, root 2 into XC1 upon RL into XC2 upon XL. XC1 is the reactance of the capacitor 1 and XC2 is the reactance of the capacitor 2. RL is the load resistance and XL is the reactance of the inductor. So this is about the filter, and this is sufficient for you to see these filters. Later on we will go the Zinner diode. What is Zinner effect and Zinner diode characteristics and specification? This is one of the article of your syllabus also, Zinner diode, and many times questions may be asked on the Zinner diode. What is this Zinner effect? With the application of sufficient reverse voltage, a PN junction will experience a rapid avalanche breakdown and conduct currents in the reverse direction. In next slides, we will see what is this breakdown voltage, avalanche breakdown. So here, you must remember, with the application of sufficient reverse voltage, a PN junction will experience a rapid avalanche breakdown and conduct the current in the reverse direction. The breakdown process depends upon the applied electric field. So, by changing the thickness of the layer to which the voltage is applied, Zinner diodes can be formed, which break down at voltages from about 4 volts to several hundred volts. And that's why Zinner diodes are available, like 6.2 volt, 6.7 volt, 12 volt, 14 volt, 16 volt Zinner diodes are available, from which we can get the regulated output also using Zinner voltage regulator. This is the diagram of the Zinner diode which you can see here. This is positive and this is negative. And Zinner diode is always used in reverse bias. The Zinner diode uses a PN junction in reverse bias. To make the use of the Zinner effect, which is a breakdown phenomenon, which holds the voltage close to a constant value, called the Zinner voltage. It is useful in Zinner regulators, as I have already told you, to provide a more constant voltage for improvement of regulated power supplies and limiter applications. What is the application of the Zinner diode? Zinner diodes are used as a regulator to provide the constant voltage as well as in case of the limiters, so that we can limit the voltages by connecting the particular Zinner diode. So this is the symbol of the Zinner diode and this is the effect. This is the VI characteristics of the Zinner diode. In forward bias, this Zinner diode will be working like a ordinary diode. If it is silicon type, this knee voltage will be 0.7. If it is germanium type, this knee voltage will be 0.3 in forward bias condition. But in case of reverse bias, after a certain voltage called as a breakdown voltage, it is also called as a Zinner voltage, the current will rapidly increase in reverse direction. This is the called as the region of voltage regulation. See here, this is current of minus 1 milliampere and this is the current is the Zinner maximum current minus, because it is in reverse, so this current is written in terms of minus IZ max, and here current limited by maximum power dissipation, P max is equal to IZ max into VZ. This is called as breakdown voltage and it is also known as the Zinner voltage. This voltage is given by the manufacturer. This Zinner diodes are particularly designed with this Zinner diode is particularly designed with this VZ breakdown voltage. A Zinner diode is a type of diode that permits current to flow in the forward direction like a normal diode, but also in the reverse direction if the voltage is larger than the breakdown voltage, known as Zinner knee voltage or Zinner voltage. Once again I will read it, try to understand it. A Zinner diode is a type of diode that permits current to flow in the forward direction like a normal diode, but also in the reverse direction if the voltage is larger than the breakdown voltage, known as the Zinner voltage or Zinner knee voltage or breakdown voltage or Zinner voltage. A Zinner diode exhibits almost the same properties, except the device is specially designed so as to have a greatly reduced breakdown voltage, the so-called Zinner voltage. A Zinner diode contains a heavily doped PN junction, allowing electrons to tunnel from the valence band of the P-type material to the conduction band of the N-type material. A Zinner diode exhibits almost the same properties, except the device is specially designed so as to have a greatly reduced breakdown voltage, the so-called Zinner voltage. A Zinner diode contains a heavily doped PN junction, allowing electrons to tunnel from the valence band to the P-type material to the conduction band of the n-type material. A reverse bias Zener diode will exhibit a controlled breakdown and let the current flow to keep the voltage across the Zener diode at the Zener voltage. The Zener diode is physically used to generate a reference voltage for an amplifier stage or as a voltage stabilizer for low current applications. So this is one of the application of the Zener diode. These are used for the reference voltages in regulators like 723 regulator and other regulator also. These Zener diodes are used as a reference. Let us say 7.2 volt Zener diode. So 7.2 volt Zener diode is used for the reference of the DC 7.2 volt. So this is one of the application of the Zener diode as a regulator. The breakdown voltage can be controlled quite accurately in the doping process. While tolerances within 0.05% are available, the most widely used tolerance are 5% and 10%, silver band and golden band. Zener diodes are widely used in regulate the voltage across a circuit. When connected in parallel with a variable voltage source, so that it is reverse bias, a Zener diode conducts when the voltage reaches the diode's reverse breakdown voltage. From the point it keeps the voltage at the value. Now, the application of the Zener diode. Zener diode as a voltage regulator. A Zener diode is an electronic component which can be used to make a very simple voltage regulator circuit. This circuit enables a fixed stable voltage to be taken from an unstable voltage source, such as battery bank of a renewable energy system, which will fluctuate depending on the state of the charge of the bank. This is the Zener diode voltage regulator circuit. Here, the input resistors are unstable voltage is applied here. This is Zener diode and you will get the stable voltage output. So this is Zener and complete circuit of the basic Zener regulator is shown here. This is the battery from where we will get the unstable DC output. This is applied to the input here. This is the input resistors connected. Zener diode, the voltage across is this VZ. And the current flowing through this Zener diode is IZ. And this is the load resistance RL, which is variable shown here. You will get the here output. Varying voltage source here. Variable load condition here. So this is Zener voltage regulator at which you will get the output voltage. Now this is equivalent circuit. This Zener diode is replaced by its equivalent voltage VZ. This current IZ. And other will be same. And this is the voltage regulation. Percentage regulation is equal to load voltage maximum minus load voltage minimum upon load voltage normal into 100. And this is unregulated power supply according to the block diagram. This is the current limiting resistor here. And this is Zener diode having the voltage VZ across it. And this is the load resistance. Within the design limits, the load resistors sees a constant voltage regardless of current. The Zener diode holds the voltage constant regardless of the change in current within limits. And the remainder of the unregulated voltage drop across the resistor, including the ripple part, this resistor. As the input voltage increases, the current through the Zener diode increases, but the voltage drop remains constant, a feature of Zener diode. This is a feature of Zener diode. Therefore, since the current in the circuit has increased, the voltage drop across the resistor increases by an amount equal to the difference between the input voltage and the Zener voltage of the diode. The constant reverse voltage of the Zener diode makes it a valuable component for the regulation of the output voltage against both variation in the input voltage from an unregulated power supply or variation in the load resistance. The current through the Zinner will change to keep the voltage at within the limits of the threshold of Zinner action and the maximum power it can be dissipate. This is all about the Zinner diode. So here, dear friends, it finishes about the semiconductor theory and diode theory as well as the Zinner diode, rectifiers, etc. And from next time, we will go for the transistor. Okay? So you go through the books, get the detailed study. If you have any difficulties, please feel free to ask me at any time. And should be communicate with our classroom also, Google Classroom. Thank you very much. Thanks.